Number four, publish your decision map publicly. If your customer decision map is not somewhere that everybody can see, then make that happen. Everybody should see it, everybody from the CEO to the dock worker. So how do you become customer focused is the question I'm usually responding to. We over-communicate about the customer to the employees. So by having a map that people can think about, this is how our customers decide to use us, they can start asking themselves questions like, why do you think they stick with us? When do they leave us? How do we get them back? The best examples are like the McKinsey customer decision journey, and you need to, I'll link that when I make the document. I'll include a copy of this, as well as that product complexity and budget control grid. But that McKinsey customer decision journey, if you pull it up, it's a simple circle, but it's got, I don't know, five spots on it, right? Your marketing team can make something like that that is easy for everybody to relate to, not a giant infographic where it has, you know, 100 different numbers on it and everything. We want something simple. That customer decision journey, I think it has five labels, and it serves as a starting point for most discussions. So what are we talking about here? Where are they on this right here? Oh, they've already made a purchase, and this is, okay, so they've already worked themselves around the circle once, and now they're on this rediscovery process. It helps get, especially if you're trying to get all your people to take responsibility for revenue. That means take responsibility for our customers. So that's number four.